Hey there, my dearest film fanatics far and wide. Today I've got an especially super video for you. It's late, but it's worth the wait. As a matter of fact, that's the theme we have for this video. I'm sure that a majority of you are familiar with the concept of coming in the clutch, and superheroes understand that more than anyone else. Whether it's a civilian about to be crushed under a giant boulder, or an ally outclassed by a powerful enemy, the hero makes a daring intervention just in the nick of time to save the day and help out their team or partner. And for this video, we'll be checking out the top 10 moments when a hero swooped in to save the day when all hope seemed lost. So tighten those capes and let's up, up and away! It's one thing to have your life in peril on land, but can you imagine being underwater during a time like that? And it's a fear that the crew of a Russian submarine were living through as their sub was hijacked by some modern-day pirates. With only a hull they've barricaded themselves into and some tools to use as weapons of defense, the crew is basically screwed. Or at least they are until a heavy force comes to the sub. It's the one and only Arthur Curry to the rescue. After playing tackle with the submarine, Arthur forces it to surface so that he can enter and one by one make short work of the pirates who only waste their ammo and break their bones in feeble shots and punches to take down this tank of a hero. And after dealing with the last of the baddies, Arthur frees the crew who all look upon him in awe. But he tells them to be quick about it as he's missing happy hour. Hey, after a successful undersea rescue, old Arthur is entitled to a victory drink. One of the most crucial last-minute saves one can make is pulling back a fellow hero from the point of no return. Lost in space and his pacemaker failing, Tony Stark records a message to his friends and family back on Earth, should it ever actually reach them. Then he just lays there in the makeshift starship, waiting for death to take him. What else is there to do? Thanos has the Infinity Stones, and hundreds of millions of people have been lost to the snap, Peter included, as the web-slinger faded away in Tony's arms in the previous movie Infinity War. Added with no way to return home, the billionaire hero has nothing to live for. Thankfully though, someone won't let it end like this. Outside of the starship, a radiant light shines in front of Tony, but it's not the light at the end of one's life, it's the cosmic aura surrounding Captain Marvel. Using her super strength, the intergalactic heroine brings the ship down to Earth in front of the HQ, where Tony's remaining friends rush to his aid.
We lost.
Miles?
Spider-Man?
Wow, Miles! You're doing it on command!
It's about time, right?
From the seamless fusion of different animation styles to the different daring spider heroes, of course we're going to talk about the helpful pinch done by the newest webhead, Miles Morales. With no time to spare, Peter, Gwen, Penny, Spider-Noir and Spider-Ham infiltrate Kingpin's underground lab so they can put a stop to him and save the multiverse. Unfortunately, it isn't long until they're caught by his vigilant drones and each spider hero suffers glitching, which takes off some of their edge. This unfortunately makes it easy for Doc Ock to ensnare Peter in the lethal grasp of her mechanical arms, and unlike other villains, she's not going to give him room to make a witty remark and wriggle his way out. But just before Doc Ock can squeeze the life out of Peter, an invisible force smacks the villainess around before revealing itself as Miles, who's rocking an aesthetic new suit and showing great control of his powers that he didn't previously have. All of his fellow spiders are in awe of this, with Peter being the most grateful and proud of the young hero.
You gotta go home, man.
Here's a throwback save for you, going all the way back to 2005 as we discuss the adrenaline-pumping last-minute save the Dark Knight did for his love interest, Rachel Dawes. After taking down Jonathan Crane and his fear-toxin distribution, Batman still had to help Rachel, who was heavily dosed with the panic-inducing poison. And if he doesn't administer an antidote soon, then the phrase, scared to death, will be taken to a whole new literal level. So you can understand that Batman has little care for stoplights or the pursuing officers as he hurriedly drives to the secret entrance of the Batcave. It takes a lot of maneuvering and deceptive tactics, but eventually the Dark Knight loses the boys in blue. Now it's onto the home stretch to the Batcave, and ever so slowly, Rachel is starting to lose it, but Batman won't let that happen. So with a boost from the Batmobile jet thruster, Batman makes a true leap of faith from the gravel path straight into the passage behind the waterfall. Luckily, he makes it and is able to give Rachel the antidote in time.
Thank you.
again. Another short last-minute save, but still one worth mentioning. Towards the action-packed end of Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice, the indestructible force that is Doomsday was truly living up to his name, tearing up buildings, killing anyone and anything he can, and so on. With Superman having been hurled into the deep depths of space, it's up to Batman to fend off this abomination. But missiles from the Batplane only seem to piss off Doomsday, which is why he has no problem shooting the Bat out of the sky. Thoroughly grounded, Batman knows he won't have any time to unstrap himself from the cockpit, not with how inhumanly fast Doomsday is. So when the Abomination blasts Batman with its optical beams, it seems like death is a certainty for him. Or at least it was a certainty until someone blocks off the optical beams, and it's none other than the sensational Wonder Woman. Even though she wasn't involved in the film as a lot of people would like, as they say, better late than never. Possessing longevity like he does, Logan's lived longer than most mutants and humans are able to. One particular save he did occurred back in 1945, when Logan was being held in a prisoner of war camp in Japan near Nagasaki. As he was being held prisoner, the atomic bombing of Nagasaki happened, and while everyone was escaping the camp, an officer named Ichiro Yashida noticed Logan peeking through the top of the whole prison. Feeling a pang of conscience, he couldn't in good faith leave him there, so he freed him. They get down there in time, but the explosion is still spreading around, with a lot of the smoke getting down into the prison. However, Logan uses the broken-off cover for the hole to cover Ichiro and bears the brunt of the radioactive blast.
No, wait! No, no, wait!
I'm sure that we can all agree that there's nothing worse than being the damsel in distress for an evil plot, especially when that plot occurs in outer space. With no resources of her own to use against Zod and his fellow treacherous Kryptonians invading Earth, and Superman unable to do much against them as they use Lois as a bargaining chip to keep him in line, what can they possibly do? Luckily, though, the AI system modeled after Jor-El is still live and active, and he helps Lois escape from the ship and take down vital information to Earth so that they can stop the Phantom Zone escapees. But not before Fiora shoots at the escape pod, which goes into a malfunction as Lois hurdles to the planet below. At the same time, Superman escapes and has a short reunion of sorts with the digital spirit of his father. Jor-El gives some reassuring parting words as he shows the Man of Steel where Lois's escape pod is falling, flying faster than a speeding bullet as he breaks through the atmosphere of space and Earth to reach Lois before the pod crashes. Luckily, he manages to catch her in a comforting embrace as they come to a soft landing on the Kent farm, where they share a tender moment before the Man of Steel goes up, up and away to end the invasion.
I know just where to put it.
And the third most notable last-minute save happened in the Avengers movie, which brought all of our superheroes together to fight against Loki and his fleet of intergalactic minions known as the Chitauri. And as if that wasn't bad enough, a nuclear missile has been activated by Nick Fury's superiors in an attempt to end the invasion by setting it on the fast path to New York. Fortunately, Iron Man gets an idea to kill two birds with one stone by redirecting the missile into the wormhole the Chitauri are coming out of and having it strike their mother ship. Luckily, the billionaire hero does manage to send the missile into the wormhole and destroy the ship, and even manages to get out before the hole closes up. Our second marvelous last-minute save was thanks to our favourite bad boy speedster. Being so quick on his feet, you have to wonder just how slow certain things that happen instantaneously go by for Peter Maximoff when he uses the full extent of his powers. Well, we got a glimpse of that in what I can say is the most smoothest last-minute save of them all. Prior to the explosion, Apocalypse and his four horsemen assault the X-Mansion and kidnap Charles Xavier, and in a well-meaning attempt to stop them, Alex Summers creates an explosion. Unfortunately, it doesn't go quite as planned, and the explosion proceeds to take out the entire mansion. However, being the speedster that he is, all of this happens before Peter like a slow motion scene, and one by one, he manages to get everyone out to safety. Given how this was a blink and you'll miss it type of rescue, I think it's more than deserving of the second place spot. Ah! And to cap off this list, we've got the number one, the most heart-pumping last-minute save of cinematic hero history. This scene was held in such high esteem that it was referenced once in the video game Marvel's Spider-Man and again in Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. During his fight with Doc Ock, the neighborhood Spider-Man and the mad scientist land on the famous NYC subway. As with any villain who plays dirty, Doc Ock sabotages the controls of the subway train by making it a non-stop bullet on wheels packed with innocent people going down an incomplete track that drops to a very painful fall. Despite being more than a little exhausted after his prior fight with the mad scientist, not to mention his mask having been lost during the fight, Spider-Man literally puts himself in front of the train and first tries to dig his heels into the tracks to stop it. Unfortunately, that doesn't work. So he shoots webs on either side of him and uses the long threads of silk to rein the subway to slow down. It's a majorly close shave, but Peter manages to pull off the biggest last-minute save a hero could ever do. And there you have it, folks, the top scenes of heroes coming in the clutch. Which adrenaline-pumping close call was your favorite? Do you have any other last-minute scenes in mind that I didn't include here? Tell me about them in the comments, and I might come up with a volume 2. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed the content, subscribe if you haven't already, and ring that bell icon to stay up to date on future videos. I'll see you next time on The TV Regent.